February 1934. A 14-year-old girl, a 17-year-old boy, got it on in the back of a 34 Ford. Shortly after that, he became known as Duane Jack Estes. It's been a wild ride. It started pretty wild. And I often think that back to that moment, probably, when I was conceived, that, you know, I was setting a pace that would not last 80 years. But it's by the grace of God that I've lived this long. And the first thing I think about this morning is that I think about gratitude. I'm very grateful. Had I not lived to be 80, I would not have had this great dog that chewed a little bit of my Kansas hat. Had I not lived to be 80, I would have not gotten to know Lily Chandler, who was born, whose birthday is also this day. I would not have gotten to spend front time with my friend, Ned Corkery, on Thursday afternoons walking in the woods. I would not have gotten to know Sammy Brioso. You wish him happy birthday today, too. I would not have gotten to coach football this fall. And I thank Coach Phelps for giving me the opportunity to still be out there and to get to know a bunch of guys that I really enjoy. I believe in angels. I believe in angels. And I have this tie, this angel tie. It was given to me by Mrs. Chandler. She bought it in France on a trip. And I wear it on special occasions. And I hope you believe in angels, because I didn't get to be 80 by myself. I really didn't. Okay. What would the 80-year-old Duane tell the 80-year-old Duane? If you got a couple hours, I could probably get that all in. I made a lot of mistakes. There are not enough erasers or deletes in the world to take care of all. But I'm going to share 3 points with you. 3 points with you. The first thing I would say to 18-year-old Duane is diversify. Now that sounds like you're talking about stocks, doesn't it? But diversify. I spent way too much time focusing in on one thing. And I don't mean to say that I don't like athletics, because those of you who know me know I do. But I spent way too much time on it. Way too much time. My adopted parents tried to get me to learn an instrument. God, have you ever heard a beginner play the violin? Oh my Lord, that's awful. They got a horn, and I couldn't do that. The piano, but I kept breaking my fingers catching baseballs and playing football. But I wish I'd done more with music. I wish I had read more. There's so many great books that I miss. I had to play catch up all my life. You have a lot of distractions these days. A lot of distractions. More than I had. But I would never have made it through this period. Because I created my own distractions. But diversify. Get involved in things. I was so happy last Tuesday when I went to a vigil for domestic violence. And these guys were singing up there. And some of them had never sung before. That was awesome. I was very proud of you guys. Very proud of you guys. Diversify. Get involved. I wish I had done more with my church. I wish I had read more. Because I had to play catch up. I was too busy. In my hometown, where we moved when I was 12, Lawrence, Kansas, that's the Kansas hat, and I'm very proud of my Kansas upbringing. The high school football team was a perennial state champion. And that's all I focused in on. From the seventh grade on, when we moved there, I wanted to be on that team. I played all the other sports, but football was it. And I did, finally. I did make the team. And we won a state championship. It was important. But I excluded a lot of other things. I had an English teacher, Gertrude Rutten. How's that for a name? Gertrude. Those are names out of the past. I had her for Latin, and I love Latin. But then I had her as a junior for English. And she really worked with me to try to get me to read more. Probably, I do remember she... This doesn't happen often in a public school. She called me at home one night because I had gotten behind. We were reading Macbeth. And she gave me these lines to memorize. Life is a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing. I wonder why she gave me that line. Like a tale told by an idiot. I do remember it. Thank you, Richard. Diversify. The second thing I would tell you is that when I was a boy, there were three things that you measured success by. One was how you got along with the ladies, the girls. Two, athletics. And three, how much beer you can drink. I only succeeded in the third one. And it does sound funny, doesn't it? It's okay to laugh. But it was too bad. When I was a sophomore in high school, a senior girl hit on me, believe it or not. Maybe she was a cougar, I don't know. But anyway, her father was a doctor. They had cars. Father drove a white Cadillac. Had a siren on it because he was a doctor. He used to go out and drive in the country. He put on that siren. Yee! It was really exciting. My parents didn't even have a car. She called me one night and she said, my parents aren't going to be home tonight. I want to come over and watch TV. Well, that was a big deal in those days. We didn't even have a TV. So I went over to her house. Rode my bike about 2.5 miles, other side of town. And and I was a little nervous. Until she brought out the bourbon. Brought out the bourbon. remember much after that. I think I must have passed out. I still remember her jarring me and saying, Duane, you gotta go, you gotta go. I said, no, my parents are gonna be home. So I still remember, I guess I'm at that point I was sort of aware. And I went out and got my bike. I probably could have gotten my first DUI right then. And I had to ride my bike home in the dark, about two and a half miles, under the influence, believe it or not. Didn't hit anybody. I'm a recovering alcoholic. And what the 80-year-old Duane would tell his 18-year-old, or the 15-year-old in that case, don't take that first drink. Because I have developed an addictive personality. When I was in college, and I said, when I began today, I said that I thank God that I've lived this long, and I wonder how. And it's been because of angels. And I did a lot of things that were stupid. And when you take that drink, you give up choice. You give up choice. And I made some bad choices. I was at a fraternity party we had out at the lake when I was in college. And everybody was going water skiing. And you know, we had our kegs drinking out there. I said, well, I've never water skied before. So I got on the water skis. Going through. All of a sudden I fell. I wasn't going to let go. I was like a human torpedo going into the water. Poor sleeve got into shallow water. I could die right then. Why? Well, I can only say that it was an abuse of alcohol that did it. And I could, you know, there are a lot of horror stories about that. Today, I'm thankful because as a result of my involvement in AA, I'm able to spend time with about 20 guys who live in a halfway house over in Canaan. There are a lot of guys just like you at 17 or 18 who got in trouble, got involved in drugs, got involved in drinking. Some of them started college, flunked out. And now at the age of 22, 23, 24, they're trying to rebuild their lives. Great guys. Some went to prep schools. Some flunked out of college, like one guy I know particularly flunked out of Bucknell. I asked him if he knew my granddaughter who'd gone to Bucknell. He said, well, I don't think we hung out in the same group. So I spend time because I'm making amends. I want to help those guys. I help them get jobs. You'll see them. You probably don't know. A lot of them don't have cars because they've lost their cars. So they can't drive. They've got too many DUIs. They're working in McDonald's around town. A couple of them are going to start back to college. I've been doing some career work with them. So I'm trying to make up for those big mistakes that I made younger. So I guess there's a blessing in that. And I'm spending a lot of time with those guys these days. So I would say don't take that break. The third thing that I would say is don't look in the mirror so much. You look in the mirror morning. Oh my God, this is sick. You know.
Well, you walk around.
fast. You look in the mirror way too much. I did. And every time I looked in the mirror, I saw imperfection. I measured what I saw with perfection. And guess what?
I would always lose. I would always lose.
Measure yourself with perfection.
You always lose.
I was always too focused in on what I didn't have and not focused in on what I did have. Because I had a lot of good things. Oh, I couldn't beat that big tackle on one-on-one. But I was good enough to at least be a guard that's beside him. That tackle went on to play at the University of Kansas and played for the Chicago Bears. Thank God he was on the other side of me. But the thing is that I wasn't happy with myself. And I guess what I would say to you is, what I would say to the 18-year-old or 15, whatever you are, don't look in the mirror so much. Don't measure yourself against perfection. Be the best you can be. Strive for excellence, not perfection. Every one of you here is a child of God. You were created in the image of God. Image. Be yourself. Enjoy what you have. Enjoy what you have. One more. Go for it. But realize that what you have is okay. Somebody asked me, how do I feel? I say, I'm okay. You're just okay. Why aren't you feeling great? Okay is all right. Okay is okay. So, I want to wrap this up. I began with a Thanksgiving gratitude. I am so grateful this morning to be able to be here. I retired 16 years ago and found my way out to this northwest corner thanks to my wife. And it's been a wonderful 16 years. And I am so grateful to have been able to be a part of this school. Granted, a small part, but a part, just to get to know people. And I look out and I see familiar faces. And I used to be able to know everyone, but that's okay. I have to learn to live with some limitations. I mentioned the alcohol. I've been having a lot of problems with balance and memory. And I saw a neurosurgeon, we did a bunch of tests. And I found a little section of my brain, some of it's missing. And part of that is a result of alcohol abuse. But what I've got left, I want to share. I want to share with the guys at the halfway house. I want to share with the football and baseball teams. I want to share with my family. We're coming together this weekend. gratitude. You know, it, one day at a time. We have that saying, one day at a time. And I'm just going to live one day at a time. Somebody said, are you going to coach next year? And I said, I really don't know. It's one day at a time. But I know that as children of God, we've been given a life. There have been a lot of bumps in the road in my life. And I made a lot of mistakes. I've learned from them. But here's the last bit of advice. Learn from your mistakes. But here's the wisdom that was referred to. Learn from other people's mistakes. Whether it's in the classroom or on the athletic field or in the walk of life. Learn from other people's mistakes because you don't have time to make all of them yourself.